Hey everyone, welcome back to new video, and in this video we're gonna see how we can perform Google sign-in with Credential Manager. What is Credential Manager? Credential Manager is an unified API provided by the Google through which you can perform user authentication very seamlessly. So let's get started with our project and see how we can do this thing very easily in our project. This project we require backend, and for the backend I'm using here Firebase. So go to your Firebase console and create a project. Give the project name. So I'm going to call this project name login. Continue. Click on the continue. Select your account, which is the default account for Firebase. Create a project. It will take few moments to create your project. So wait for it. Okay, so our Firebase project is ready. Click on the continue. So we are in the dashboard. So first I'm going to attach my Android application into this project. So simply click on this Android icon. We have to put few information in here regarding the application. So go to your build Gradle module app level. This is our application ID. Simply copy this application ID, come back to your project. This is your package name. Next, the application nickname. So I'm going to call this login with Google. Lastly, we have to pass our SHA1. So let's pass it. Go to your application, open up your terminal and simply execute this task signing report. This is our SHA1. Copy this thing, go back to your project and paste in here. Restart the application. Okay, so we will download this file later. Simply click on next and continue the console. Okay, so in here, first I'm gonna set up authentication in this project. So click on the authentication, get started, choose the method. So I'm choosing here Google. Enable it, choose the email and save it. Now simply download your googleservices.json file. By the way, the same application is also created in your Google Cloud console, and from that Google Cloud console we require a web client ID that we will use in our project. So after this thing we will do that. So download the file, go back to your application. Change the mode from Android to project, and in our Android app module, I'm gonna put that file. So open up your Finder, go to the download. This is our file, simply drag and drop in here. Okay, so this is our Google services.json file. Now go back to your console, click on the done. It's time to go in our Google Cloud console. So this is our Google Cloud console. Now it's time to open up the project that our Firebase had created in this Google Cloud. So click on here, just refresh this tab so that it will come. Now select your project, go to the all, you can see login. Click on the login, API and services, go to this credentials and create a credential. So click on here. This is a OAuth client ID. Application type is web application. You can give the name of your web application. I'm using here login name so that it's more consistent. Okay, so simply click create. So for our requirement, we have to use this client ID. So simply copy this client ID, come back to our Android project, and in our first, I'm gonna change this mode from project to Android, and in our resources, values string, I'm gonna paste that thing. So string web client ID. So this is our web client ID that we will use in this project. Okay, so now go back to your Google Cloud, simply click on OK, and we are pretty much done with our Google Cloud things. So now it's time to begin with our Google sign-in journey in our application. But before that, make sure to add all of these dependencies. By the way, this dependency you will get from my GitHub repository. On the top, make sure to add this plugin, and your build Gradle KTS project level file, make sure to add the same plugin. Now it's time to begin with our class. So first I'm gonna create a class in my login package, and the class name is Google sign-in utils. This is a class that has companion object in it. We have a function in this naming do Google sign in. We have to pass few parameters in this function like context. Next, we have to pass coroutine scope. Next, launcher. Type is manage activity launcher. Input is intent and output is activity result. This is a nullable type. Lastly, we have a function naming login. So once we perform login, this login function will trigger. Requirement of this thing is credential manager. So let's create this thing with the help of credential manager. Create, pass your context in this. Next, I'm going to create a request with the help of get credential request builder. We have to add credential option in here, but before that, let me build it. Now it's time to provide our credential option. So for that, on the bottom, I'm going to create here a function naming get credential option. Pass context in this. Return type of this thing is credential option. So in order to get credential option, I'm going to use get Google ID option. Follow the builder pattern. First function is set filter by authorized account. Suppose the same user have been used an account for sign in to your application. Next time when he want to sign in with the same account, set filter by authorized account. So in this you can pass true or false. So what will happen if you pass in here true? Suppose you have the application and you perform the sign in before with some credential. Now you want to perform sign in another device or the same device later. So what it will do? In the prompt, it will show the same login that you have been previously used. So if you want that behavior, you can pass here true, but I don't want that behavior. I'm using here false. Next, we are having here set auto select enable. So if you pass here true, it will automatically select the previous account that you have been used. Otherwise, it won't. So simply use false here. Next, we have here set once. So in this, you can pass a string by using a various kind of algorithm. What it will do, it will simply make the reverse engineering complex. That's all. So I'm not using in this get Google ID option. I'm simply build it. But before that, make sure to attach your server client ID. So this is coming from our string file. So get a string r.string.webclientid. That's it. Now use it. Get credential option, pass the context. So we have our credential manager, we have our request. Now it's time to perform the actual network request, or you can say Google Cloud Server call. But before that, this is a network request call. Sometime it will throw an exception. So just use try catch and catch this exception. So first exception, which is no credential exception. Suppose user doesn't set up Google account in their device, then we will receive an exception, and this exception will be catched by this block. What will happen? We will use our launcher and simply launch an activity using which user can set up the Google account. So for that we require an intent. So let's create the intent function get intent. Return type of this thing is intent. Let me make some space for you. Return intent. We have to mention the action. So for that, use settings.action add account apply scope function. I'm gonna put some extra in it. That extra key is also coming from settings.extra account types. Use here array of com.google. Now use the intent in here. So get intent. Because this is a nullable type, so use question mark. Okay, so this is the first catch. Next catch is for the general credential exception. So use here credential type is get credential exception. In this scenario, I'm using simply print stack trace to print all of the information regarding that. Now let's execute the actual thing. So in our try, I'm going to create a variable naming result. Use credential manager dot get credential, pass our context in it and the request. Okay, so get credential is a suspendable function, so we have to use here coroutine. So for that, I already passed scope. Simply launch a new coroutine and put all of this thing in this coroutine. Okay, so now we have the result. So it's time to check the result. So result credential. If it is a type of custom credential, then only we will proceed. Otherwise, we don't do anything. Okay, so if it is a type of custom credential, let me make more space for you. Then we have to check few things like result.credential.its_type, and this type is coming from Google ID token credential.type Google ID token credential. If it is equivalent to this, then only we will proceed for the login. So first I'm gonna grab my Google ID token credential with the help of Google ID token credential.create from. Here we have to pass the data. Now data is coming from result.credential.data. Next, we have to fetch the Google token ID. This is coming from our Google ID token credential.id token. Now it's time to create our auth credential. So let's do that with the help of Google auth provider. Import it. In this we have a function get credential. So requirement of this thing is our Google token ID, and for the next parameter I'm simply pass here null. Now we have auth credential. It's time to perform the sign-in operation with the help of Firebase. So use Firebase authentication sign-in with credential. Requirement of this thing is auth credential. Simply pass it. Use await. It will give you user. Now simply take the user in our user variable. Check if user is not null and it is not anonymous, then only we will trigger our login lambda. So yeah, that's it for our do Google sign in function. Now it's time to use it. So go to your main activity, and here first thing first, we have to create a launcher. With the help of remember launcher for activity result, in its context simply use activity result contracts dot start activity for result. We have a button. In this column we have a very basic button. Now when user click to this button, what we will do, we will use our Google sign-in utils dot do Google sign-in. We have to pass context, so let's create the context with the help of local context dot current. Next we have to use scope with the help of remember coroutine scope. Just create a variable for scope. First we have to mention our context in this. Next we have to mention our scope in it, so use scope. Lastly we have to pass our launcher. So for the launcher we have launcher on the top. For the lambda, use here login and open a pair of parentheses. So this is happen when user click to this button. What will happen when we successfully set up the Google account for the device? Then simply use the same thing and execute it. Requirement of this thing is context scope, so cut this thing out and paste on the top of our launcher. So for the launcher, just pass null this time. Okay, so once we perform the login, I'm gonna simply show a toast message. Pass the context, next the message. So in the message I'm passing here login successful. Now simply copy this toast message and paste in here. Alright, so we are pretty much done it with it. Now it's time to execute our application. So first I'm gonna execute this thing in my emulator, and in my emulator I haven't set up my Google account, so just execute it. Okay, so we have a problem, and the problem is not related to the Google sign-in. It is related to some version things. So simply convert this thing from 34 to 35. For the target SDK, just change it, sync your project and execute one more time. Okay, so once I click Google sign-in, see, this is the activity through which you can add your Google account. Now I'm going to execute the same application in my physical device. Okay, so now when I click Google sign-in, you can see I'm able to see a bottom sheet, and in this bottom sheet it will give all of my credential. So let's say I'm using here gaming with Himanshu. Continue with this and see, login is successful. Alright, so by using this approach you can perform Google sign-in with the help of Credential Manager. It's a very cool thing, because now it is very easy to use Google sign-in in our authentication. Otherwise previously it is not that much easy. We have to do a lot of things, but now it's easy. Alright, so I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, subscribe this channel and also write your comments. We'll meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about Android. Till that, goodbye.